Oh, we got an animal on the loose.
I tried to ruin the shot.
Good job, you nailed it. Three, two, one.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Arit here, and we have another adventure for you. In fact, we've been wanting to go to this place like for so long. You know when you want to go somewhere and you keep saying, oh, I'll go there next time, or someday I'll go there. Well, this time we're actually going, and we're going to the Britannia Mine Museum. I'm not going to say much about what it is right now because you'll see all about it in the upcoming clips. So enjoy, and let's take you on this trip together.
So this is a vlog, and I've started it now. Just getting some food before we go. Is this my sandwich?
Thank you.
Is mine?
That's yours.
Okay. Let's check it out. Yep, good to go. Okay, so apparently we're almost here. We're almost here, right?
Yeah.
We're like half an hour.
Yeah. So you're gonna change your demeanor now that we're filming?
Yes.
There's Arit enjoying the sceneries.
Great.
If you guys,
I think it's across from here somewhere.
Oh, I think if you guys ever have a chance to come to Whistler or ride this highway here, it's an amazing view. Never get old of it.
4.5 stars.
4.5 stars, TripAdvisor. Here we go. This is the Britannia Mine Museum. This used to be abandoned, and they used to film X-Files here.
Really?
Yeah.
And before that, it was an actual mining area.
Yeah, and they, yeah,
they
actually mined here. So here we go. It says, come explore, which is what we're doing. Here we go. Enter tickets this way. Here we go. This is so cool.
Oh, light jacket or sweater is recommended.
It's cold down there.
No pets allowed.
I got your pin on camera. 2 tickets. The train ride leaves at... Hold on, it's not focusing. 2. Okay.
Head up for the guided tour at 1:45. So okay. Right now we're here, so you guys can explore this area for a bit. After the tour, you can come back and explore more. But for the tour, just follow the yellow orange dots all the way to the top of the stairs.
Okay.
Do you guys each want a map?
Yeah.
I'll get one more. Yeah.
Thank you.
So this giant rock here is copper. You can see here the raw material, copper rock. Interesting. Venture. Wait, are we going the right way? I don't wanna... But I wanna look at this stuff after. Well, what's happening? Okay. We're making our way to the tour. I'm sure there is an elevator. Is this the tour?
These are the train tracks that will be going down into the black hole. Also known as the mine. Looks like this will be in fashion today. Thank you. got an animal on the loose.
I tried to ruin the shot.
Did good job, it? You nailed it. People never came back.
Everyone is so mad, Daddy!
We need to talk about a few things, including safety. So there's two rules on this tour. Rule number one, hard hat on your head at all times. Rule number two, keep all of your body parts inside the train. And those are the only two rules that are there for your safety, so please make sure you follow them. And that's a signal. It's a signal from me to you, my passengers. I'm telling you all that I'm about to start driving the train. So when you hear the bell, make sure you're seated and be aware that it's a little bumpy when we leave this terminal. And that's normal. It gets smooth as we go along.
All right, so we are on this little train thing and we're about to go in the mines.
It's video.
Whoa, here we go. We are entering in at 2 something. Oh, we can't see. It's blurry.
203.
We're going in at 203. Here we go. Whoa, it's cold.
It's cold. Are you cold?
Yeah.
Shoot, it's cold.
The rocks are wet.
I know. The rocks are wet in here. Wow, this is cool. This is so cool. You guys, if you want to do something, definitely do it. Try something new. It's really cool. I got it. Whoa. Some kids are freaking out.
Over 100 years ago. This stick I'm holding is representing dynamite, but it ain't real. Okay? Actually, some people on tour do think it's real, and it's funny, but it ain't. Thankfully. But when we're dealing with real dynamite, of course, we need to be very careful. Can you guys hear anything in this tunnel right now if we're silent?
Water.
That's correct. Water is dripping in underground mines all the time. That is the nature of underground mines. And although normal dynamite is dangerous, wet dynamite is far more dangerous. Oh.
Someone dropped a head.
Yeah, it's okay. Here, I'll get it. And I think it's a bit wet, so how about we just go without the hard hat until we get to the other side, hey?
Mines.
What we used here was that one. It's called the wood drill. This mine opened in 1904. And in those days, there's no such thing as gender equality. So women are not allowed to work here. Women are not even allowed to enter this tunnel that we're in right now. So that's weird, but that's how it was. And that means it's only men working here. Let's pretend we're all young men. We would have been exposed to this drill, but that would have been bad. And I'll tell you guys why. This drill is different than the rest of them here. All of these drills to my right, well, they're wet rotary drills, which means, well, the wet part, it means that they use water. Wet drills use water. Rotary means that they spin. Those are wet rotary drills, but this one's completely different. First of all, it's a dry drill, no water used, and it's a percussion drill. So it's not really like the drill you might have at home. It's more like a jackhammer. It's hammering away at the wall to produce the hole. And that's old fashioned. We don't like dry percussion drills, that's why we stopped using them. And here are the top three problems that we would have using a drill like this one. The dust, the noise, and the weight. And I'll start with the weight. Look how big this thing is. It weighs 275 pounds. I can't lift that by myself. And every time I'm starting a new hole, I would need help from a couple of my coworkers to move this. You'll notice that we have all these hoses coming in here. They're attached to the machines, and they're bringing compressed air from the outside. Our underground equipment is powered by compressed air, even in 1904. That's what you guys are gonna hear first. I'm just gonna put my safety equipment on. Before I actually run the drill, I will do a countdown. That's what I'm gonna cover your ears. This is just the air. Alrighty. 3, 2, 1. Cover your ears tight, buddy. Here we go. They're filling up ore bins and sending those ore bins to the mill where we're turning this stuff into metal. But the life of a mucker was very difficult in the early days. Who wants to guess how many tons two guys would move in 1 8-hour shift? Okay, so they worked in teams of two. How many tons should a team of two guys move in one day? What do you guys think is fair?
One?
Yeah, I would say that's fair. What do you guys, do we have any other higher guesses? Because unfortunately one is quite low. Right.
Oh.
3, 40.
10.
No, not 40. But you know what? Let's just stop. It's 16 tons.
Wow.
2 people.
16,000 kilograms for two guys in 8 hours, which is very difficult. That's 1 ton an hour per person. And you're doing it with this shovel here. Yeah, actually, a lot of people say that shovel's small. I think they did it on purpose. Because it was big, it'd be too heavy for you to flick it over. We need small ones so you could flick the rock quickly. That's my theory, okay? Just David's theory. I don't know if that's actually why, but that's what I think. Come to here. Now it is on. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Why you don't have to be very nervous is because our exit is 10 meters away, and if you're really uncomfortable, all you have to do is turn your head. There will be daylight over there. I encourage everyone to look down this way instead. Get a feel of the darkness, even if it freaks you out, because that's what it was like to be a real miner. Underground mines, they don't have these overhead lights, the active ones. Why? Well, as I mentioned earlier, anything inside the mine will get destroyed, including those lights. And no company wants to destroy their own lights every day. So it's much more simple to just have dark mines, and whoever goes inside could just bring their own light while they're in there. Let's see what they had in 1904. So I'll do a countdown and I'll turn off the lights. 3, 2, 1.
Whoa. Oh, cool.
Welcome to 1904. And this is our source of light here for the first 17 years.
Wow.
Can you guys imagine operating that first drill we saw? The Widowmaker, and this was the source of light for that, so we could all imagine how difficult that must have been.
Yeah.
Let me show you how they managed. So here we have a candle pick, right? So that goes into the wall, and you mount your candle, and it's hands-free. Just like a notebook today. But of course, this is not a good source of light. I can't see any of your faces. We're standing pretty close to each other. So something better came along in the 1920s. Slightly better. Not this LED light. Basically, as close as you can get to an LED light in the 1920s. And that looks like this. This is a calcium carbide headlamp. Calcium carbide is a rock, and it's the source of fuel for this device. And it's not a rock that you'll ever find outside. It's a man-made rock, our source of fuel. And we have some in the bottom chamber right now, and I'm about to add a little bit of water. And when the water trickles down and mixes with the rock, it starts a chemical reaction, and we're producing acetylene gas, which I'm gonna combust so that we could have light.
Ooh.
There we go. So this is what it looks like. And this is a lot better than what we had before, right?
Yeah, much better.
I mean, we could almost see to the end of the tunnel. I could see all your faces. You wear this on your head. Here's that we made it out safely. And in the old days, they were communicating lots of different things, depending on how many times you pull it. So today I'm pulling it once. Once is enough. It's very, very loud. Everyone cover their ears. Yeah, nice and tight, nice and tight. 3, 2, 1. All right, now we can.
Yeah, I did. I put the camera down. It's probably loud on the camera.
You have to break the sound.
You can feel that in your chest.
Yeah. We made it. That was the sound. We all made it. Justine, you made it. I don't think you'd make it as a miner.
This is actually mill number 3, which implies that there was 2 mills before. What happened to them? They're not around anymore. So let me tell you, mill 1 used to be where we got onto the train. But that's a pretty small spot for a mill. It was tiny and it was inefficient. By 1915, they built mill number 2. Mill number 2 was the opposite of mill 1. It was huge, the biggest mill in British Columbia, very grand. But it didn't last long. Mill 2 burnt to the ground after only 6 years of operation in 1921. No one was hurt in the fire, but now we have no mill. If you guys want to see the ruins of Mill 2, simply look behind me on the inside. You guys can see those foundations and some wood, some parts. That's what remains of Mill 2. So we're in a lot of trouble in 1921. We have no way of processing this ore that we work hard to bring outside. But they didn't want to give up on this place, so they built mill number 3. That took a year and a half, which may sound like a long time, but remember, it's the 1920s.
Whoa, this is so cool.
Welcome to mill number 3.
Wow. Wow.
Pretty steep steps. Those are not regulation stairs. And it goes up 375 steps, and that's not even the top. It's not a museum gimmick. This same thing is happening all over the world so that we can enjoy metal. Water coming out of the mountain. It just rained recently, so it's probably happening right now. And then we built.
All right, the tour has ended. And we're free to roam around. This looks really cool. I love stuff like this, seeing history and just like how things were back then and how they've changed. Go in. Wait, let me look there. Whoa, whoa, whoa! Watch out, Ari! It's gonna get wet. What's happening? There's water spewing out. Watch out.
I'm sheltered.
Why is there water spewing out?
This is a really small car, and it would fit like 12 grown men in here.
Go in. Okay, go.
Oh, 12 people?
Come in here, Boldy.
12 grown men. Let's go to work, everyone.
All right, off to the mines. Here we go.
We're going to work.
People my ass.
We're going to work.
This sucks.
It's the transit.
Can you imagine that?
Wow. This is the transit.
You'd go in.
It's cool.
What is spewing out of water here?
Let's just not ask questions and just run away with it.
I guess these were all the machines used. So crazy. They're all so big and heavy. Justine, you said you wanted to be a mucker? There, of muck and muscle.
This is my coworker.
This would be your cart. We can go climb that after. Let's do the gold panning. Grab one of these things? What do we do? How do we do this? I don't even know what we're doing. Scoop it. Okay. Then shake it. Then dip it. Then fill it. We're gonna get some pan for gold here. Ugh, okay. Got some. Okay, scoop it. And then what are we doing? Shake it around. The heavier gold will sink to the bottom. Shake it. Shaking it. Okay.
It's not working for me.
You have to have the water, right? You're not reading the instructions. You have to get it all loose and then dip the pan in the water to wash out the sand. You get it, right? Okay, hold on. You getting anything, Boldy? It's pretty hard, eh? So we got one gold little flake while planning for gold. Both Arit and I got one. It's really tiny. It's at the bottom.
Oh, yeah, there is this.
You can see it, right?
Yeah. Really shiny.
I don't think you can see it from here. It's too small. We'll try and film it later. But we got one. We got two pieces. Okay, hold it. Keep holding that. Reed is really into the gold mining right now. Panning for gold. You got anything, Reed?
I did. I got. Check it out.
Let's see.
It's tiny.
Yeah. I can't really see it. It's too hard.
Right there.
It's hard to see it. Nailed it.
Got it.
You really know how to work that thing. Oh man, you would die.
Go pretend like you're dying. Okay, Arit, push the handle. Crazy. That was an actual blasting box that they used to use to explode the dynamite. Let's do it again. What?
Alright, so that was it. We are leaving. Oh.
Oh, sorry. Hello. I got a Himalayan salt lamp.
Show the size of it.
Yeah, it's pretty big.
So she got this. Heavy. It's inside. They taped it up. Himalayan salt lamp.
Right? Yeah, it looks spicy.
Justine choking on jalapeno chips. So we're back from the copper mine and we're now at the Flying Beaver. It's this cool place in Richmond and you're like by the water. Right now we're on the patio, but it's like on the water and seaplanes fly in and out of here. So it's kind of like an airport as well. And we're all pretty hungry, so I'm gonna be getting this bad boy burger. Let's see if I can get it on camera here. The bad boy burger. Let's see how that goes. Gotcha. Here is the bad boy burger with mac and cheese. Arit got, what'd you get?
Butter chicken.
Steen got a margarita pizza. Same as the peony in the blog, if you remember. And Boldy has the beef dip. You got it, Steen. Here, stand, go, stay in the outro with Arit.
Oh, I don't want to be in the outro.
One.
Hey guys, so we had an amazing day at the Britannia Museum. We had some dinner just now at the Beaver, Flying Beaver. They have seaplanes coming out here and they're flying to Victoria and the island and stuff. So we had an amazing dinner here and we're wrapping this up. Thank you guys so much for watching and coming along with us on our journey. This vlog is really all about encouraging you to explore and be adventurous, do new things, go out there and live life, because that's really what it's about. It's about feeling good and making the most out of this life. So there you guys have it. I will see you in the next video. Bye. And that's how we're ending.
Back from the dead. We'll be right back.